Hey guys, it's Bro You Whack. Welcome to the top 5 best workshop game. Hold on a second! What happened to the meme? What happened to making the top 5 best maps the meme of season 3? Y'all let me down, really. Really, you let me down. Well, you guys voted, and by a landslide, you made the top 5 best maps win for this week's top 5 episodes. So today, we're gonna be looking at the top 5 best map. So weird to say that, because I've been saying it's in the pool. Oh, I'm having a midlife crisis right now, and I'm only 4 years old. So whenever it comes to the best maps in any kind of video game, we always gravitate towards our favorite one. If it's in Super Smash Bros., obviously it's going to be the Pokemon Stadium. If it's in Black Ops 1, obviously it's going to be Nuketown. Here in Overwatch, surprisingly, at least for me, there's never been one map that I always favor over the rest of them. That either can mean that they're all great or really trash, and I honestly really think that all the maps in Overwatch are really good. It's just the game modes that can suck sometimes. Really, it's just one game mode and it's 2 CP. So for this top 5 episode in particular, I'm gonna be adding a little rule where I have to include at least one map from every single game type. That includes Assault, which is 2 CP, that includes Escort, which is just a full-on Escort map, a Hybrid, which is a Control and an Escort map, and a full-on Control map. That way I can at least satisfy all the 7 people that like 2 CP maps, and everybody else that loves Control maps, well, you're not really just gonna be seeing a list of just Control maps. I wanted to keep it fair, but also not boring. Where everyone loves a control map and everyone hates a 2CP map. It's all even, and you can still all hate on me and roast me. But before we get into that, you know what time it is. It is time for you to get a watch and to vote for next week's top 5 episode between the top 5 best workshop game modes versus the top 5 worst maps. I figured, hey, we're doing the top 5 best maps, we have to do top 5 worst, so let's possibly do it next week, unless you guys want to see the workshop game mode video. So finally getting into the list of the top 5 best maps. Remember, we have to include a 2CP map, so of course at number 5 it's gonna be a 2CP. It's basically picking the best of the worst maps, but I decided at the number 5 spot we're gonna go with probably one of the most beautiful maps in all of Overwatch, which is gonna be Hanamura. Out of all the options that we have for 2CP, we have a map like Volskaya or Horizon Lunar Colony, and they're just straight up bruh. And then you look at Hanamura and be like, yeah, I hate 2CP, but they have cherry blossoms. They have great Japanese architecture. There's little tiny details in the wood. The splinter is beautiful. Gardens and whatnot. So, as terms of the aesthetics, I feel like this is the best map, not only in 2CP, but in all the maps in Overwatch. But of course, the aesthetic only lasts about 2 seconds because you realize, hey, there's a Widow, Symmetra, and Hammond on my team that's completely thrown. We have to win. I don't care about no cherry blossom, boy. So, how does the map actually play out? So compared to other 2CP maps, I usually have an alright experience whenever it comes to Hanamura, yes, even though it ends up in a draw 9 times out of 10. But when it comes to the very first point, it's a very unique first point because you do have that giant bell right in the middle to give you a little bit more added protection, plus you overlook this big giant hill which gives you opportunity to get environmental kills. So really, when it comes to the first point, yeah, I would have to say that's a pretty good first point, but the fun really starts when you get into the second point of Hanamura, and you're gonna see that routes play a heavy part in deciding where I put a lot of these maps or why they're actually on this list to begin with. And when it comes to Hanamura, there are 3 main ways that you can enter this point, all very unique. When it comes to the main entrance, which is kind of ironic because no one really enters the second point through the main entrance way unless you're just going into overtime, which happens a lot. Mainly everyone goes on the top right where you want to control the high ground or at least control that big open catwalk that's over overlooking the point. And especially when it comes to overlooking the point, Hanamura has so many ledges that you can't really access that well. And I've seen a lot of cheese when it comes to the high ground, like teleporting a Bastion and Orisa on top of that high top ledge that only really a Widow can get up to. Like, there is so much unique stuff about Hanamura that I feel like not a lot of people are talking about because of the fact that it's 2CP. So Hanamura, I think, is one of the best 2CP, even though yes, it's 2CP. But at the number 4 spot is gonna be a map that I think is totally underrated in my opinion. I don't hear enough people talking about this map, but it has a beautiful scene, so many Easter eggs, and I think it plays pretty well, and it also gives opportunities for so many heroes. And at number 4, that's gonna be Watchpoint Gibraltar. Watchpoint is a pure escort map where you're escorting Winston's shuttle to his rocket. Like, it's so cute how they have this map set up because it's Winston's office overlooking the beautiful ocean, the scenic view, and the sunset, which actually allows for certain skins to somewhat be advantageous on this map. Some people won't argue that, but you know, it provides a unique atmosphere nonetheless. But even the architecture of this map is uniquely designed as well, because on the very first point you have this big giant dip, which not a lot of escrow maps do to begin with. Like on Route 66, it's all flat. On say Rialto, it's all flat. Here you have that big giant dip, which I really do like because it adds a little bit of not only character but some unique play styles that you can possibly take to your advantage. Like, I love using Mei on this map because I can overlook the enemy, wall them up, and they have no way of getting out. One, because it's a tight dip, but also two, I have the high ground, Anakin. And then throughout the second point, you all play around the big giant shuttle that's in the middle of the freaking map, and you can even get on top of the shuttle. So really, when it comes to the second point, there are some interesting stretch that you can play around just based on the design of the map. And then the third point is very open, but still provides a lot of old opportunities just based on that skinny catwalk that's right in the middle of the map. Like, you can drop down with a Reaper ult, you can use a Soldier ult from the high ground, or you can just hide there with Fair away for the grab and concussion blast and Raid Justice! At the number three spot is going to be our very first control map, which might come as a surprise for a lot of people because they might suspect that the number one and number two spot should be control maps, but I decided to put this one at number three, and it's going to be a classic in my opinion, and that's Lijing Tower. For me personally, there aren't a lot of maps that I get super hyped about whenever I see it in the rotation, and I truly believe that's because I like and enjoy most maps and the way that they're designed. But when it comes to Lijing Tower, surprisingly, there's not a lot of quirks to it. Like, yes, there are some, but there aren't a lot of quirks that you have to play around with. Like, you have to play specific heroes, say on like Rialto, you obviously want to try to play Roadhog or Orisa or Pharah because you can boop them around the first bridge. But when it comes to Lijing Tower, that vanilla that it brings is something that I really do like because it leaves it open for really anyone that you want to play. And especially when you look at the map specifically, like with the first map, Night Market, again, a very vanilla structure where the point is in just this little tower area, and you don't really have to worry about the environmental kills that much. Even though that they are there, it's not like on Ilios or in Well that you have to worry about, okay, I can't fall in this or, no, you just have to play in the box. And the garden provides a little bit of breathing room if you don't want to be in that claustrophobic first point. But when you get into the second map, which is Garden, this is probably the most unique one out of the three because of the fact that you do have the bridges that you have to worry about when you are going to come from spawn onto the actual point. But even then, it just depending on how aggressive or passive you want to play on those maps. If you want to play more passive, you're going to go on the left side where you have kind of like the more buildings on the left versus the right side where it's more open, where you're more sustained to environmental kills from the Hammond or the Pharah or the Lucia, which I honestly love about this map because of the fact that you have options. You don't always have to go to the bridge side, even though that is kind of the most effective way. No, there's just an effective way on the left side if you don't want to be suspect to environmental kills. And then finally, when you're on control center, once again, a very vanilla structure with that big beam in the middle of the point being really the only unique part about this map. Yeah, you do have that high ledge that you are able to get to if you flank all around, and you kind of have that health pack ledge as well, but again, it's just a very vanilla map that doesn't really restrain you on any kind of strat because it is so open, and because there are a lot of opportunities, you can do a lot with it. But for the second best map in all of Overwatch, I think is going to be a very classic map. Like, when I think about my first experiences with Overwatch, I always think about this map because, well, it was one of the first and one of the most memorable, and that's going to be Hollywood. Just the name alone tells you that this is going to be a good map. I mean, Blizzard can't make a map in their hometown, which is in Hollywood, California, and not make it a flame map, all right? And they deliver on the hype, because I want to believe that this is one of the coolest looking maps in all of Overwatch. While Hanamura is the most beautiful, this is just straight up cool and quirky and unique. There's just so much going on with this map. This is a hybrid map, so of course you have to capture the first point to ideally access the rest of the map, but even leading up to the very first point, you're in the streets of California, there's cars everywhere, and then you go up into the gates of Hollywood, you enter, and then you're fighting right in the middle of like a cafe, a building, there's even an elevator that's so many Torbjorns love to put their but then when you actually do capture the point, then you get to escort one of the quirkiest things about Overwatch. I love this. It's the freaking limo driver. I know on Watchpoint you have the shuttle or whatnot, but here, this is the coolest payload. I might do a top 5 best payload, just payload, not even payload maps, because this thing, it's just so funny. He's all talking to you. He's all yelling at you. He's just roasting people. He's typical Hollywood actress. And then you get into the different scenes of this map, entering the first point that you obviously get the gates of Hollywood, but then you get this cowboy scene with the bar and the bank and the jail, and you're just escorting it through the alley, if you even want to consider it. Surprisingly, even though this is a pretty tight-knit map, it is very open because of the fact that it's outside of the studio. But then you enter the studio into like the space theme area, which that makes me love this map, is the fact that they have different themes as if it's regular Hollywood, and they play out extremely well. Not only does it look great, but the gameplay is beautiful. You have ledges, you have elevators, you have high ground, you have catwalks, you have health packs strategically placed in perfect areas. There is so much room for activities in this map that I can't go into detail and explain to you why I love every single part, because this would be a 20-minute video. I'm already at almost minute 11, and I haven't really fully explained my appreciation, but hopefully I got my point across. This map just provides so much unique opportunities, and it's well designed, and it's just honestly so memorable for me.
But it's not better than number one. No, no, no.
Every single time I see this map, or any single time that anyone sees this map, everyone gets excited. And it's all because of the memes, it's all because of the potential, and it's all because it is just so beautifully designed, so uniquely designed, and this is gonna be Horizon Lunar Helios. Helios. You knew Helios was going to be somewhere on this list, but when I was thinking about the top 5 best maps, what I really wanted to do was look at the list, really go through every single map, and thinking about, okay, well, why do I like this map? Is it because of the quirks? Is it because of the gameplay? Is it because of how it looks? And I already knew before I started the process of making this video, Helios was probably going to be number 1. And it's all because of Well. Like, even though Lighthouse and Ruins is well designed too, Well is... It's so cool, man. You have this freaking giant well that you have to worry about. So many boops from Lucio and Pharah, so many pulls from Roadhog, and so many throwing players have gone into that well, and I think this makes it the most iconic map just for that fact alone. But then you go onto a map like Lighthouse, which honestly is surprisingly claustrophobic. I think that is the tightest point out of not only control maps, but all the points in general. Like, you're literally in a rectangle, a 2x3 rectangle, looking like the closet I just came out of this morning. Hold on a second. And then you go on to Ruins, which has a distinct look because the point is actually indented into the ground. Like, you have to go on stairs to get to the point, which provides a unique experience as well. Honestly, Helios, there is just so many quirks to it. And I know I just keep saying quirks, quirks, quirks. But Blizzard, the company itself is very quirky. The company itself adds so many different little things to every single map to make it not only unique, but also play extremely well. And that's why I don't really have a favorite map that I favor over all the other maps, because they're all good. They're all great. Yes, even the 2CP maps. Yes, even Volskaya or Paris more recently. There's just so much with every single map that I love and appreciate every single one. And that's why it was somewhat hard to make this video, because, okay, well, what are the distinct features that I like about every single map? That's why I chose Helios. That's why I chose Hollywood, because there are extremely distinct features for this map. But I want to know what your top 5 favorite maps are from Overwatch. Leave it in a comment down below, and I'll be sure to not cry too hard when you tell me, oh my god, you forgot it's Route 66 or something. I love you guys. Thank you guys for watching. More Overwatch videos to come, and bye.